although it is a test is available, we have to use it judiciously because there's not enough tests for everyone to get tested just because they're concerned. People to be tested are those who have the appropriate symptoms, potential exposure history, a potential travel history, or admission to the hospital with a severe respiratory condition, which is not explained by an alternative or different diagnosis. Those presentations, along with expert assessment or clinical assessment, along with consultation with our health department colleagues, will ultimately lead to the decision as to whether we test or not test for the new coronavirus. It's not as simple as walking into your primary care doctor and say, I'd like to have my cholesterol checked. It's not quite that simple. There's much more nuance, and it's a combination of the appropriate signs, symptoms, exposure, travel, etc. For the recommendations of someone being tested, the patient has to meet the appropriate clinical criteria, some of the epidemiology criteria, and the doctors assessing the patient have to be convinced that this is a reasonable test to run. Then we work in close collaboration with the health department to coordinate the testing with the state lab, and that patient is given a person under investigation number with the health department for the coronavirus test. There's really two scenarios here, depending on how sick the patient is. If the patient is not sick enough to require hospitalization, then the patient is triaged or sent back home with oversight by the health department for home quarantine or home isolation until the test is confirmed or ruled out. Okay. The other option is, or other scenario I should say, is that the patient is sick enough to be admitted to the hospital. And if that's the case, then with an admission to the hospital, we have to use the appropriate protocols in place to make sure that not only the healthcare workers are safe, but the patients are placed in the appropriate environment, a single room with no roommate, for example, with negative pressure. That means that the air is going into the room but not coming out of the room. Okay, and that there's minimum involvement of healthcare workers and staff going into the room, have the dedicated just right amount of healthcare workers taking care of that patient during the time of investigation, confirmation of testing, or even illness if they're confirmed positive. To our understanding right now, about 80% of all cases are not serious or not severe, and they don't require hospitalization. 20% are severe enough to require hospitalization. Of that 20%, the minority require intensive care unit level care.